The Nokia 5.1 Plus, the phone that's known as the X5 in China. While the competition has been hiking prices, HMD Global seems to be going the other route. Their first two generation phones were priced closer to tier 1 brands, but now with the 6.1 Plus and this 5.1 Plus, HMD Global is offering a lot of bang for the buck. Today, let's unbox this phone, spend some hands-on time with it. Hey guys, Ash here from C4E Tech, regular card giveaways. And please, if you can, do hit that bell icon, turn on notifications. And by the way, we're also gonna be giving one away. So let's get started. We have the usual Nokia box here with the spec highlights to the back, and we have the branding on one side. Enough about the exterior though, let's slide the box open and have a look inside. First up is the 5.1 Plus itself. Let's take it out of the protective plastic. Damn, the glossy back does look good. Let's set it aside for the moment and see what else is there. We have a SIM ejector pin, a few information booklets, a Type-C cable, and a 10-watt charger. Getting back to the 5.1 Plus, like I said, the glossy glass back does look good. The sides seem to be made out of plastic. The cameras are a little elevated. The fingerprint scanner positioning seems fine. And there is a little Android One logo at the bottom too. Now, along the top edge, we have a 3.5mm headphone jack. There's also a secondary noise cancelling microphone. To the right, there's the regular power button and volume rockers. The left, there's a tray. This is a hybrid tray, so you can either pop in two SIMs or a SIM and a micro SD. And to the bottom, here's where you find the speaker, a USB Type-C port, which is amazing because most phones in the segment come with micro USB. We've even seen phones priced a lot higher that have come with micro USB. So kudos to HMD Global for putting a Type-C port here. And of course, apart from that, there is also a primary microphone. The front, it is dominated by the 5.86 inch IPS LCD panel. It's similar to the one found on the 6.1 Plus, except for one difference. The difference here is the resolution, it's lower. This is a HD Plus panel, but it looks bright, the colors seem fine. The notch is a lot larger here, and it's not because they're doing something extra, it is just how it is. This notch houses the earpiece, sensors, and an 8-megapixel f2.2 selfie camera. The screen-to-body ratio is quite good, so the phone feels very easy to use single-handed. Of course, it's a glass back, so the regular cons that come with a glass back, like fingerprints, smudges, slippery back, and all that apply here, but it does feel good. The 2.5D glass all around does help with the in-hand feel, the ergonomics. Now, the 5.1 Plus, as good as it looks, it's not just about the looks. The internals are quite kick-ass too. Well, the 6.1 Plus had a Snapdragon 636. In a weird turn of events, the 5.1 Plus comes with the even better Helio P60 chip. Yes, it's a MediaTek chip, but the P60 is closer in performance to the Snapdragon 660 than the 636. And given the HD Plus display, the lower resolution there, I expect it to perform very well on this phone. We've already seen it on phones with full HD displays like on the Realme 1 or the Oppo F7 F9 Pro, so it should be doing really well here. It's stock Android after all, right? When it comes to memory, we've got 3GB of RAM to go along with 32GB of storage, and there's a 3060mAh battery providing juice. Now, we did touch upon the software, so this is stock Android 8.1 Oreo on board the Nokia 5.1 Plus. Remember, this phone is like all other phones from HMD Global sold as part of the Android One program. So this is plain vanilla stock Android with very few Nokia touches. On the flip side, HMD Global has an amazing track record when it comes to updates. Even their most budget-friendly devices, even they get constant security patches and firmware updates. So that is definitely a selling point. Expect this to be one of the first phones to get Android Pie. Now, given that it's stock, we have Google's trusted face for face unlock, works well. The fingerprint scanner is fast and accurate, and there is no bloat. I mean, you are seeing a few apps here. That's because we did not shoot this footage till I ended up setting up my phone. I thought the guys did shoot the footage, so a little bit of miscommunication there. There is no bloat, nothing preloaded except for the regular Google Apps, the bare basics. So that is a definite plus. Talking about pluses, you're not going to be seeing ads anywhere on the user interface. That seems to be a positive these days, given what the competition is doing. Anyway, jokes apart, the camera is one app where Nokia has changed things. We get a wide array of options, including AR stickers and picture-in-picture. The hardware, it is a 13-megapixel f2 primary with face detection autofocus, coupled with a 5-megapixel depth sensor. The images you're seeing were shot with these cameras and, of course, the 8-megapixel selfie one. Note that there is a portrait mode option for both the front and rear cameras. So how do you think the cameras fared? Let me know in the comments below. And now with that, we get to the pricing. Now, we don't have the official 5.1 Plus pricing as of now, but the 6.1 Plus launched in India for 16,000 rupees. That's priced at 1300 yuan in China, so about a 14% price hike from the Chinese price. So based on that, given that we do know the 5.1 Plus's price in China, I'm gonna say it should launch in India around the 12,500 rupee mark. And if it does come in at that price, it should be a good option because the Realme one did extremely well. Yes, this is a lower resolution display, but it's got the fingerprint scanner and, of course, what people love, stock Android. So, you know, you've got stock Android, high screen to body, assured updates, the powerful Helio P60 chip and all that in a build that looks the way it is and feels good in hand. The low res display, like I said, might be the only major negative here. So what do you guys think about the 5.1 Plus? Are you excited for this? Would you be interested in picking one up? Let me know in the comments below. And by the way, our Poco F1 giveaway is almost done. And I know you guys love Nokia phones, so it is added, why not give one away a 5.1 Plus? So let's do that. As always, it's pretty simple to enter. Use the link in the description below. Make sure you're subscribed to C4E Tech. That's all. You can improve your chances by following me on socials. This time, this is gonna be only India. Sorry guys, maybe the next time we'll do global. This giveaway is gonna run from today till the 6th of October, and the winner will be announced on the 8th of October via Twitter and YouTube community posts. If you happen to miss both, you can still check out the winning entry via the same Gleam link you used to enter. So good luck with the giveaway, guys. And now it is time I bid you adieu. Thanks a lot for watching. Till next time, my name's Ash. You've been watching C4E Tech, and I'm signing off for now. You guys have a great day. Bye-bye.